guys, Glenn here.
Yeah, so Line 6 just released their new version 2 firmware, which gave us what they call snapshots. Now, snapshots is basically, they give you 8 settings, different settings, all laid out at the same time. And so you can have different settings in the patches for each one of the 8 buttons or the 8 snapshots. Now, I was coming close to something like this before they came out with the snapshots, and one of my patches was is the 3-channel amp, and it was good and I still use it a lot, but with the new snapshots, it's a lot better. Now, you're gonna have to update your Helix firmware, and you're gonna have to also reset it, because with version 2, they changed a lot of things deep inside the operating system of the Helix. So you're gonna have to basically update your Helix, and that'll rebuild all the patches, and you'll have to reload your favorite patches. So first thing you have to do is, using the current editor that you have, save all the patches that you can't live without, okay? Now, I'm not gonna go into that because you should already know how to do that. So I'm gonna show you how to update your Helix with the new firmware, and then I'm gonna demo my new snapshot patches for you. They came out really nice and I love the way they sound. And one of them uses the new Mesa Boogie Mark IV model that Line 6 added. They've also added a few new effects. One of my favorite one is called Vintage Delay. You can actually, with this Vintage Delay, you can actually set how the sound degrades as over time as it repeats. I think that's really cool. It's fun to mess around with the different effects you can get. Anyway though, let's go ahead and first off, remember, save your current patches using the current Helix editor that you have. Save everything that you can't live without. Now, once you've done that, this is how you update the Helix to the new version 2 software.
Yeah, so here's my desktop. Now, what we're gonna do is go to Google and just type in up at the search Line 6 software. And that will take us to the Line 6 website where you can get the software that you're gonna need to update your Helix. So, as we see here, it says Line 6 software. We click on that. And now in this part, you're gonna wanna scroll down to the Helix and click the go button, and that'll take you to the software. Now here we are, the new version 2. Now you're gonna really read all these instructions carefully, guys. Please read them and follow them to the letter, okay? Especially the one number 7. That's where, when you're finished updating, you will have to reset all the global settings in the Helix. So this one here is what we need to download. You go ahead and get that, download that, and save it to your desktop. Now I have a folder here set up. It's called Line 6 stuff. So go ahead and save it to that. And it shouldn't take long. It's not a very big file, depending on how fast your internet connection is. It should load right up there. So as you can see, it's downloading. Okay, now, once that's done, now we're going to go to that folder where it was downloaded to, which is right here, Line 6 stuff, and we're going to run that. Install the software. This should only take a less than a minute to do. And this will install the new updater software and the new Line 6 Helix editor. Okay, so now that's all downloaded. Let's update the Helix. Okay, now at this point, you'll want to have your Helix plugged in. We're going to start the updater software. It's going to ask for your username and password, and now there's Helix. Open that up, and there you see version 2.0. Go over to the right, hit the update button, and keep going, hit all the continue and accept. And now here we go. This will update your software in the Helix. It's gonna take a little while. It should take a few minutes, normally maybe 3 or so minutes. Now this is what your Helix should look like while you're doing this. So you can just go grab a cup of coffee or something while this is taking place. By the time you get back, it should be done. Now after the process has completed, your Helix will restart itself, and then it's going to rebuild the factory patches. And while that's taking place, that may take a little bit longer. It actually took me maybe 3 to 4 minutes for it to update all of the patches, the stock patches. Now this is what you'll see when it's updated and the Helix will restart. And this is what that would look like on your Helix. It'll just restart and then it'll rebuild all of the presets. Okay guys, now here is the final and most important step of this upgrade process. After your Helix has updated the firmware and it's restarted itself and rebuilt the patches, you want to turn it off and then hold these two switches, the number 9 and 10 switches, hold them down both at the same time and turn it on while you're holding it down until you see on the screen where it says we'll reset globals and presets and IRs, then you let them go. Now I'm not going to do that, I've done that already, so I'm not going to do it again, but that's the last step. So you have to perform that, and that's going to wipe out all of the presets and rebuild them. And that's why you will have to reload your favorite presets back into the Helix. Once you've done that, you're all set to go with Snapshots.
Okay, so I hope that helps you guys out there. Some of you may be a little bit intimidated by this kind of stuff, but as you can see, there's nothing to it. You can do it. Now I'm going to demo my Snapshots patches. I made these available on my website. You can go grab them there. And again, guys, thank you so much for your continued support. I am in the middle of working on my Custom Artist Presets Volume 2 package, and that's scheduled to be released in August. And I think you're gonna really enjoy that. But these particular snapshot patches are really cool. Now, I've done all the programming for you. It's really deep. It goes way farther beyond just turning things on and off as you press the buttons. There's a lot of deep editing that I did in these things, changing parameters and everything. It's super complicated, and if you're not into editing, it won't make any sense to you. So I've taken care of all that for you. So if you're into just getting patches, putting them in there and start playing right away, well, you can do that with these. So let's check these out. Okay guys, now there's a few settings I'd like to go over with you, some of my global settings. If you press the little hamburger button to the top left of the unit, the one on the right above the preset knob, press that and then go into your global settings right here. Now, you see this guitar pad on? I have it on. You can either have it off or on. I find that when it's on, for some reason, I get a better sound. I guess my guitars are pretty hot. So then let's go down to the foot switches menu. Now this here is how, this knob here is how you set how the unit reacts. Now I have it set on stomp snap, which means the bottom row is snapshots and the top four buttons on the top row. You still have other effects that you can turn on and off at will on all of the different snapshots. Now, if you have it set on 8 snapshots, all 8 buttons will have snapshots. So you can have 8 different settings
on each one of these snapshots, but you can't turn, you won't, once you're on one snapshot, you won't have the ability to turn other effects on and off unless you go into the manual mode. You press the mode button, which I will show you in my video. So I prefer to have mine set on stomp snap. And again, that means the bottom four switches will be the snapshots. And I find four is really all I need. And then on the top row, I have four individual effects that can be switched on and off. And here's what that looks like very briefly. You see, four snapshots here. And then on the top row, individual effects. Now, whichever scene you're on, say if you're on snapshot one, and you can go into manual mode, and then you'll see different choices. I have a Univibe that's actually hidden. You can't see it when you're in snapshots mode. Again, the same thing for 2, 3, and 4. Any one of these, you can go into manual mode. If you want to stay there for a whole song and turn things on and off. But the way I have these engineered is you basically have four different, totally different sounds. And then each one of these top buttons can go on and off at any given time in any one of the snapshots. Now, one thing you got to remember, if you say, for instance, if I press this chorus on and I'm on snapshots 3, when I go to snapshots 2, it's going to be set to how I have it set. But when I go back to 3, that chorus is still going to be on. That's the thing about snapshots. It remembers everything you turn on and off. So you can have up to 8 different ones, or you can have up to 4 and these separate effects here. Now you can also have the snapshots on the top row and these 4 on the bottom row. I prefer the snapshots on the bottom row. So that's just a quick overview of how this all works. Now let's listen to these sounds that I've come up with for these new snapshots. Thank you.
Thank you.